Confronted primarily with a moral issue. It is as old as the scriptures and is as clear as the American Constitution. The heart of the question is whether all Americans are to be afforded equal rights and equal opportunities.
It's really tough to do a campaign. You have to walk around and tell your ideas to people. Some of them like you, some of them don't like you, but some of them love you. And when it works out, your ideas will come to life. And what would you do if you were president for one day?
And we'll all feel gay when Johnny comes marching home.
If I'm the president for the day, I'll make sure every child, every kid has free education, at least all the way up to tertiary education. A nation where everybody is educated, it'll build us on average. Everybody will be a part of at least the better society.
If I was president for the day, I would make sure that all children across America had an equal education.
If I was president for a day, I would make a law that would allow higher education to be for free.
If I was president for the day, the first thing I would do would be reform public education. All of it.
Okay, let's look at that. Hello? Hello, everybody. Thank you for being here tonight. Is education a right or a privilege? And why does it cost so much? There are lots of free education, billions of pages of books in public libraries across America. Another thing to think about is the price of higher education. Prices are out of people's incomes range. Is knowledge only for the rich, or does anyone have the right for knowledge and wisdom? Are you looking for a high-paying job, or will you invest in yourself and start your own business and stimulate your own economy?
Čo by som urobil? Zničil by som všetky zbrane a priniesol lásku a samozrejme zdravie pre všetkých ľudí.
So if I'm president for the day, I really try to put some much stricter guidelines on assault weapons, on guns. I really feel like if you look at the US, you look at the country versus other industrialized countries, we have a much higher incidence of gun violence, much higher incidence of school shootings, of mass killings for no reason. You look at major cities around the world, Chicago for instance, the incidence of gun death are way, way too high. And I feel like the president needs to take a step and make this an issue. You know, there's no need. I understand the Second Amendment, but you know, I'm sure the framers, the founding fathers never saw an Uzi before. And if they had, they wouldn't say everybody could have one. You know, we don't have a militia anymore and it's a different time. And I think gun violence is a huge issue. And so if I'm president, that's the first thing I'm tackling.
First thing I would do is look into our own backyard and I would bring some peace, love, and stop all this hatred and racial that we have. That's what I would do.
The question is, what type of world do you want to live in? A world of fear, hate, and weapons? Or people loving and respecting and honoring each other? I know the world I choose. Another great question is, who really, really runs our world? And how did this happen? More important, how can we move into a higher vibration of love and away from fear and hate? Like Michael Jackson said, it doesn't matter if you're black or white, yellow or red. As humans, we will stand as one people in love, without hate and fear. That day is almost here, my friends.
If I was president for the day, I would house all the homeless veterans in America.
If I were president for a day, I'd probably push a motion to turn a lot of the golf courses into homes for homeless affordable housing. Just in general, there's a lot of like waste of space. You know, golf is pretty nice, but how many open patches of land do we really need, you know?
If I was president for a day, I'd change a lot of living, cost of living first, and then, you know, try to mesh everyone together, not, you know, so that way the economy wouldn't be messed up, you know what I'm saying? I would change a lot of the tax laws, and I would make it easier living for commuters when they're going to work.
I believe all veterans that have served our country have a right to freedom and dignity and a clean place to live. People are people, and some are hardworking and ambitious. Others don't care to work as hard. There can be a balance to connect the income classes that works for everyone, and we can all get along.
I would take all the ignorant people and put them in one place, one island. One single island, so they could all be there in the island, you know, all ignorance and do the whole thing. You know, that's about it.
如果我是中国人，如果我是总统，我在每个地方都放 WiFi， 让所有的人都可以用。
I think I will have National French Friday.
Hell if I know.
Well, first of all, because humans are not sheep or cattle, it's not nice to control or lock up other humans. We can't say these humans are good and these humans are bad, so let's put them here. That's not going to work. Free Wi-Fi or free French fries? That's interesting for sure. As president, most likely not the most important ticket on the agenda. And I certainly understand not knowing what the heck to do. There's a lot of moving parts to running a country.
Se eu fosse presidente por dia, eu ia gastar apenas dia para pensar apenas nos negócios pequenos e médios. Dia. Se todos esses negócios crescem, o país inteiro vai crescer sozinho. É isso.
This country was built on small business and entrepreneurs. Before there were corporations, there were mom and pop shops, small and medium-sized business. It seems that somehow the corporations took over and changed the rules. It's good for corporations and not as good for people. A person will always work harder for themselves and their family than for any company or any boss. That's the American dream, freedom, and the time and money to live your dreams.
Si fuera presidente por un día, primero tiraría la pared que quiero hacer, por lo mismo de que soy mexicana. Y bueno, también lo que buscaría sería como la paz mundial, ¿no?
Если бы я стала президентом на один день, я бы уничтожила все границы между странами, чтобы стало путешествовать намного проще.
Aš manau, kad aš aplankyčiau daug skurstančių šeimų, aplankyčiau senelių namus, aplankyčiau vaikų namus, tam, kad suteikčiau jiems laimės bent tą vieną dieną. Kadangi aš būčiau prezidentė tik vieną dieną, aš daug pakeisti negalėčiau, bet tikriausiai būčiau žymus žmogus. So, vien dėl to aš bandyčiau suteikti laimės kuo daugiau žmonių, išklausyti jų istorijas, nes kartais išklausimas gelbsti.
Si yo fuera presidente por un día, prohibiría que, bueno, haría todo lo posible porque no construyera el muro, porque soy mexicana, y en su lugar lucharía por que todos fuéramos inclusivos, iguales y por la pobreza.
Si yo fuera el presidente por un día, yo abriera las puertas de Cuba para que vinieran todos mis paisanos cubanos a los Estados Unidos a ver su dream, su sueño. Principalmente mi hermana, que espero por ella, Amarilis Quesada.
No boundaries, no border guards, no borders, no border lines. Everyone and everything is equal. That's interesting. That means we have to get along, all 7 billion of us on planet Earth. think the place to start is ourselves. When we can get along with ourselves, we can get along with others. How do you get along with your neighbors and with people you meet? Borders and border guards and boundaries are put there to protect you from someone or something. If there's no one or nothing to fear, then we can all get along as humans. I think an open door policy will work if people respect and honor each other. The USA started that way. Our grandparents came here on boats to Ellis Island. I believe we need more love and kindness and less fear, and our country and our little green planet will prosper. As Spock said, live long and prosper. We can and we will when people drop their guard and their fears and just love each other. When we are president, we will teach all that will listen to create the world that we want to live in. God bless America.
When Johnny comes marching home again, hurrah, hurrah, we'll give him a hearty welcome then, hurrah, hurrah. Oh, the men will cheer, the boys will shout, the ladies, they will all turn out, and we'll all feel gay when Johnny comes marching home, and we'll all feel gay when Johnny comes marching home. Get ready for the jubilee, hurrah, hurrah. We'll give the hero three times three, hurrah, hurrah. For the warrior Reeve is ready now to place upon his loyal brow, and we'll all feel gay when Johnny comes marching home. And we'll all feel gay when Johnny comes marching home. In 1861, hurrah, hurrah, that was when the war began, hurrah, hurrah.
And so, my fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country.